I'm here with one of the best trainers in boxing, Virgil Hunter, the trainer of Andre Ward, the trainer of Amir Khan, the trainer of Pero Angulo, just to name a few. So coach, first of all, Pero Angulo, his third fight, second fight with you?
Third.
He's stepping into the ring against a very, very tough fighter with Arislandi Lara. How do you see the fight unfolding?
Well, you're right, it's going to be a tough, tough fight. And we're prepared for a tough, tough fight. It's going to be a fight of attrition. So everybody should really tune in Saturday night. You know, it's going to be a tough, tough task for both men.
There's a lot of talk on the internet, so we don't know if it's confirmed. But Amir Khan, Devin Alexander, if that fight does happen, and they say maybe Dubai, how do you feel about that fight?
Well, Dubai sounds nice, but the fight's going to be also tough. You know, and Kevin Cunningham's a friend of mine, and I've been knowing Devin since he's been a kid, so you got a lot of mixed emotions in the fight, but it is going to be a tough, tough, difficult fight.
I'll move on. We just saw Carl Froch. He fought and he took care of business that he had to. And then he was like, I want to fight Andre Ward in England. What's your thought on that?
He doesn't want to fight Andre Ward.
He just said it?
Nowhere. He said it because the mic was in his face and then all the cameras was on him. And he just said the politically correct thing, but deep in his heart, he don't want to fight.
And if the fight does happen, same result?
Oh, much worse. Much worse.
Because Andre had the broken hand the first fight.
That definitely played a factor in us not doing, being able to do what we intended to do. But it doesn't even matter if the hand is broken, it's just going to be worse.
Like a wise person just told me, why go backwards? Why not go forward?
Well, there's two schools of thought on that, I guess. But in boxing, going backwards and forwards, if it makes you money, you got to do it, you know?
As the boxing aficionado that you are, you notice, but what is it about Mayweather Canelo?
Well, you know, I think that if that kid doesn't correct his stamina issues, he's going to have a tough night. Simple as that.
How about Pacquiao, Brandon Rios?
That's a 50-50 fight. Both men, Brandon is coming off a real tough fight, and Pacquiao's coming off a real tough fight. And I think it's going to be a fight of attrition, and it's a dangerous fight for both men. You know, both men in each other's wheelhouse. So it's a dangerous fight. Brandon Rios is a dangerous guy. And, you know, Pacquiao's proven that he's formidable. So.
And Coach Brandon Gonzalez, is he still with you?
Brandon's still with
you. Very talented fight. He has a big fight coming up as well, right?
He sure does. He has a big fight coming up that is determined. You know which direction his career is going to go in. He's preparing right now. I look for him to be victorious and, you know, and enhance his career and, you know, take some steps towards being in the top 10 and, you know, showing the world that he's definitely a player in the super middleweight division.
Thank you very much. Coach Virgil Hunter, look out for him. Stay tuned for EsNews.com and my SecBack reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @SecBack.